Hi guys, Guitar Interactive, NAMM 2020. It is the end of day one. I'm sat with John from Celestion. John, how you doing, man?
I'm doing fantastic, Nick. How are you doing?
Just about getting there, but I'm happy to be here, right? So, hello, we made it. This is always the busiest day for everyone. Yeah, absolutely, man. But it's been wicked so far.
Absolutely.
We're still at the booth. We've got a whole array of speakers.
We do, yes.
A very underappreciated part of the tonal chain, I think.
Exactly.
I agree.
Well, a very significant one, nonetheless.
Well,
right?
Maybe it's the thing that actually physically produces the sound.
Absolutely.
So, you know, this is something if you guys aren't into, you need to get into, and we're going to talk about the speakers and try and twist your arm into caring a little bit more. So, I'm sure all our readers are very, very well informed. They all understand this stuff, but just in case you don't. So, what do we have?
Okay, so here is kind of. This is the highlights of our current range. You know, you got from the EVH signature speaker, which is basically a greenback. It's Eddie's favorite greenback. You know, we took it, we put a black can on it, we put the EVH stripes on it. And it's a beautiful thing to behold, and it sounds like a vintage greenback. You know, you've got a creamback, which is the idea behind this range. Was to make a kind of a hot rodded greenback. So for those guys who want to downsize from a 4x12 to a 2x12 cab, for example, 265 watt greenbacks, 100 watt head, no problemo.
Yeah, you got it. And there's the medium and the heavy, and the sound
is
very different.
Yeah, different power handling, yes.
Yeah.
And you got the neodymium one down here, which tonally is kind of in between the two. Ah. But the beauty of that, of course, is
unbelievably light.
Look at that, it's like 3 pounds or something.
Yeah, I mean, this is something that's kind of, it's of interest to a lot of guitar players who are downsizing cabinets because they don't want to lug around big heavy cabs, but it's not always the bulk, it's the weight as well. Four of these, you can have a 4x12 that you can carry on your own.
I mean, the extreme example of that, if you step around here.
Yeah, let's go.
For those guys who want the extreme power handling and the extreme lightness and weight, we've got the copperback speaker here, which is the same kind of weight, 3 pounds, 250 watt power handling.
Unbelievable.
If you're insane enough to need that kind of stuff.
Yeah.
But I mean, and this is for those guys if you like the EV12 kind of tone, very clean, very high headroom, not much breakup. This is the speaker.
This is for you.
That's the speaker.
Interesting, man.
This came out a couple of years ago now. It's kind of slowly getting out there into the marketplace. Not everybody knows about it, so we kind of want to talk about it at the show this time, you know. But
it's very cool. I mean, I work quite closely with the guys at Victory. They've just dropped 180 watts pedal power amp, and this is the speaker they're pairing it with.
There you go.
In a 1x12, so, you know, like, if you want 180 watts through a 250 watt handling speaker in a box this big.
But you don't want to break your back lugging that around, this is the kind of speaker you're going to need.
Man,
look at that.
Totally, yeah, you know, I mean, it's interesting because people are downsizing, but more people are getting into stereo and wet dry rigs and stuff, you know, if you're carrying a couple of cabs. Yeah. Two of these in
weight
a pair
is
of 212s.
A consideration.
Totally, you know. And if you're shipping things around the world, if you're a touring artist, or, you know, I know a bunch of guys who are just getting on a bit and don't want to carry huge cabs around, but you still want to push some air.
Absolutely,
you know? Speaking of pushing some air, this is my favorite right here.
The Redback, you demoed that a few weeks back.
Man.
But that was kind of a similar consideration. And this is 150 watt power handling, but as you pointed out, it's much more of a conventional sounding. Guitar speaker, it's got all the comb breakers, it's a little more vintage than this would be. It's a lovely sounding thing. I mean, I like it for the real extreme metal sounds. It's got a 2-inch voice coil, which gives it a bit more bulk.
I know what you mean. I mean, it's the kind of low end thump that you can only get from the speaker end. You can't dial that in.
No.
It's different if you dial the bass up in the amp. This is physical air being moved by a lot.
It's the physicality of it that gives it that just.
Yeah, it's
good.
It's good, really. You know, I mean, when we did the review, we did it at Tom Quayle Studio. And we had matching 212s. The one with the Redbacks, we were physically moved by it. It was like, this is big.
It's good.
It's real big. It's really, really good. And there's another, like, an old favorite down here as well. The Hot 100.
K100.
So,
again, that became very popular with the real aggressive metal guys, maybe a dozen, 20 years ago. Like Kerry King.
I was going to say,
years, you know,
that was his.
So it's that kind of thrash metal kind of vibe to it, you know. Mm. Or when they start, when they first started down tuning.
Yeah, yeah.
This can kind of withstand that. It's got a very tough voice coil. It's got quite a heavy cone, and that's why it can withstand that down tuning.
Yeah, no, wicked, man. So for extended range stuff, this is cool. Actually, this is also equally cool. You've also got the FX 120?
The F12X200.
That's the one.
Yeah.
Terrible at numbers. But let's take a look, because a lot of guys who are doing the downtuning thing are moving to modelers.
Yeah,
and,
exactly.
You know, for a variety of reasons.
Profilers. And those guys are using the full range flat response thing.
Yeah.
And that's really cool, but they tend to use PA speakers for full range cabinets. And that reproduces the whole bandwidth very accurately.
Yeah.
But what tends to happen is that you lose a little bit of the feeling.
Yeah.
You know, that tactile feeling that you get from playing a guitar speaker.
Yeah.
PA speakers don't feel quite the same.
No.
So what we did is we created this for those guys who are missing the guitar speaker feel. So what it is, it's a coaxial speaker. So this is kind of the woofer.
Yeah.
And underneath the hat here is a compression driver, which does the high frequencies.
Yeah.
And there's a crossover built in.
Ah, okay.
So you've got an HF driver, a crossover, and then a more conventional woofer. And we've used a guitar speaker cone, which is thinner and lighter than a PA cone. And it just feels more like you're playing through a regular guitar speaker.
Yeah.
You feel a bit more connected. Can you feel the emotion
a little
bit better? You know, you stick this into a cab and it'll feed back like a guitar speaker does.
Brilliant.
And a PA speaker would never feed back.
Doesn't do that, no.
I
mean, there's a bunch of implications for that. I mean, first of all, you can use a more traditional looking cab. You can use a more traditional form pattern with your modeler. But, you know, if you're doing drop and goes and you have your modeler, and you have an engineer who wants to put a 57 in front of a mic, if you have an FRFR cab that's got a tweeter and a whooper, you need a mic and bow. They're in the same place.
So they're in the same place.
Throw a mic in front of it.
You put your mic a couple of meters away just because that's the best way to do it.
Really. Yeah, yeah.
But, yes, there's no mic in the HF or mic in the LF separately.
Yeah, yeah. So that's really, really cool, you know.
Yeah,
and, of course,
it is.
The field thing. The other thing with this is, of course, brought a range of IRs over the last few years.
Yes, we have CelestionPlus.com is where we sell our impulse responses. So we saw that kind of move in the marketplace a few years back, and lots of companies started selling IRs, and there's guys like Redwires and Onhammer, and they're really cool, doing really cool stuff. But we thought that didn't quite sound like what we thought our speaker sounded like.
Uh-huh.
So we kind of wanted to reclaim our tone.
Yeah, yeah.
So we thought the best way of doing it was to make our own IRs and just make them available for people who wanted that. You know?
It's a great idea.
So rather than focusing on the cabinet, we focus on the speaker.
Yeah.
You know, and so this, whichever is your favorite Celestion speaker, you can get an IR of it.
It's made
by our guys, you know.
Yeah.
And we've got a real top of the range recording studio, which is just around the corner from our HQ, which is great.
Perfect.
You know, Grammy Award winning engineer helped us sort it all out. And,
I love the way it's all laid out, because, you know, it's not like these kind of like the old IR libraries that I remember from 10 years ago, where it was maybe about 10, however many years ago, where you'd have, you know, cone edge 1 inch, cone edge 2 inch, cone edge 3 inch, which is fine, but you know, for guitar players, we want a much more
intuitive.
Like, absolutely, you know.
Yeah.
So you have, you know, these mics blended, a bright version, a dark version, a roomy version. It's just like, it's exactly what you want. It takes the option anxiety.
You don't want it to be too scientific.
No.
You want it to be just a bit more intuitive, and it's what's that going to sound like? Oh, it's going to sound dark. That's going to sound light, you know?
Yeah, yeah. Very cool.
We find it helpful. So.
Yeah, totally, man. And it's a great way to audition speakers.
Yeah.
If you know, if you're interested in changing your speakers out, which you should experiment with. But it's a great way to kind of figure out what works for you and what doesn't by getting hold of the IRs, because they're only a few quid. You know, like, it's as opposed to, and you don't have to take your cab to bits or any of that kind of business
exactly
until you're ready to commit. Very, very cool. Well, listen, John, thank you so much for your time. It's been a pleasure.
Awesome.
It's been a pleasure. Expect some more speaker stuff from us later on this year, because I'm very passionate about this, so more coming. Our NAMM 2020 coverage continues. We'll see you in a bit.